You're watching PTS English News. I'm Stella Chu. Topic of the day, March 11, 2011. Japan's most powerful earthquake on record triggered a tsunami, which then caused a meltdown at the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. Three reactor cores exploded, releasing the highest amount of radioactivity in the environment since the Chernobyl nuclear disaster. Now, Japan says it will release more than 1 million tons of water into the sea from the destroyed Fukushima nuclear power plant this year.
In March 2011, a magnitude 9 earthquake hit Japan's Fukushima, triggering a powerful tsunami that flooded into the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. It was the most severe nuclear accident since the Chernobyl disaster in 1986. To prevent the debris from overheating and causing further damage, water had to be pumped in to cool the reactors. Furthermore, groundwater and rainwater flowing into the reactor buildings created additional contaminated water. About 1.32 million tons of contaminated water are being stored in more than 1,000 tanks on site, and now it's running out of storage space. Back in 2016, the Japanese government and experts started to look into the contaminated water issue, and in 2021, the Japanese government announced the approval of the plan to discharge nuclear contaminated water into the ocean after a 2-year buffer period. In August 2022, Tokyo Electric Power Company Holdings Inc. began the construction of facilities to release treated radioactive water into the ocean. According to TEPCO, nuclear wastewater will be treated with the Advanced Liquid Processing System, ALPS, so the concentrations of radioactive materials other than tritium sufficiently satisfied regulatory standards for safety. Since tritium cannot be removed, it will be diluted with seawater to the Japanese government's discharge standard before releasing.
The IAEA review is carried out in an objective, credible, and science-based manner and help send message of transparency and confidence to the people in Japan and beyond.
Experts of the International Atomic Energy Agency have visited Japan several times to ensure the radioactive treated water would not harm the human body and the environment. However, there have been protests in countries nearby the Pacific Ocean, including China, South Korea, Taiwan, and also Japan. The anti-nuclear NGO group Greenpeace stated that the Japanese government has been too optimistic about the ALPS and worried that there would still be radioactive substances in the treated water, and the substances could enter the food chain after the wastewater being dumped into the sea. Japanese fishers also expressed concerns over the issue as it may affect the local fishing industry. Taiwan's Ministry of Foreign Affairs said in 2021 that it has reached out to Japanese authorities to require Taiwan's rights on the issue and demanded that Japan should share information transparently during the process. In the two following years, government teams and civil groups successfully visited Japan, paying close attention to the water discharging plan. For the safety of Taiwan's aquatic products, the fisheries agency explained that since the Fukushima nuclear disaster, it has cooperated with the Fisheries Research Institute, the Atomic Energy Council, and the Food and Drug Administration to keep close tabs on the food inspection. They will continue to do testing of aquatic products in the future.
So on today's program, we have Ye Zhongguang. He's a professor at the Department of Engineering and Systems Science and an affiliated professor at the Institute of Nuclear Engineering and Science at National Tsinghua University. Hi, Professor. Welcome to our program.
Hi, everyone. Good to be here.
Good to see you. As we mentioned, Japan plans to release Fukushima's wastewater into the ocean this year. And what's the impact if the water is dumped into the sea? Also, within how long do you think it would be spread to Taiwan? Professor Ye.
Yes, that actually depends. The reason I'm saying that is because we have to make sure that the water that is going to be dumped into the ocean contains no other radioactive isotopes. So when I say other radioactive isotopes, I mean other than tritium or carbon-14, are there any other radioactive isotopes like cesium-137 or even strontium-90? That's my major concern. However, according to the statement released by TEPCO, They said the ALPS system, which is the advanced liquid purification system, they said the ALPS can actually filter out all the other radioactive isotopes except tritium and also carbon-14. So if that is really the case, then I'm not really worried about the dumping of the wastewater into the ocean, because according to their procedure, their plant procedure, they are going to dilute the water. I mean, that is to reduce the concentration of tritium. And we know, according to what they have declared, the tritium concentration in the wastewater would be less than 1,500 becquerel per kilogram of water. So that is way lower than the restriction set by the Japanese government, which is 60,000 becquerel per kilogram of water. And it's also less than the restriction set by our government, which is 50,000 becquerel per liter seawater. So I think that's acceptable. But like I mentioned earlier, we have to make sure that the tritium is the only, tritium is the only primary radioactive isotope in the wastewater. According to the data released by TEPCO, I know they said there are no other isotopes, but I really want to know if other organizations have also investigated the wastewater and make sure tritium is really the only primary radioactive isotope in the wastewater, okay? But I haven't seen that. I only saw that visits by IAEA or even by Taiwanese delegates to the site, but they only monitored the process, the procedure. They didn't actually get into the measurement and the investigation of the wastewater. So I don't know if we have a high faith on the Japanese government and TEPCO. Maybe we can believe the wastewater to be released into the ocean contains only tritium. So that's why I said that depends.
Right. So right now, basically, we have to trust the data provided by the Japanese government at this point?
Yes.
Okay. Now, even if the data released by the Japanese government seems to satisfy regulatory standards for safety, how would it really affect Taiwan? And what does this mean for most Taiwanese people?
Okay. First of all, I want to emphasize that the ocean stream flowing near Taiwan is going upward to the Arctic Ocean. Okay, so according to the estimation by researchers, it would take about 18 months for the water released near Japan to be near Taiwan. In that case, after 18 months, even the water reached Taiwan area, the concentration of tritium is very, very low, very close to the natural background. So in other words, we really don't have to worry about the influence or so-called impact of the tritium in the seawater, because tritium is already in the seawater by natural causes. So with the dilution process conducted by TEPCO, and it would take a very long time for the water to reach Taiwan, I don't think it would have any significant impact on people's life in Taiwan. So we don't have to scare ourselves, okay? Because in addition, our government is doing the measurement by ourselves. So we can have a look at the government's data to see if there are any influence of the radioactive isotope coming near Taiwan.
And of course, many people are wondering, could this be the only way, releasing the treated water into the sea? Is it true that there aren't any other options, or is this the cheapest, or some say, could it be the most convenient solution out there, Professor?
Well, it is the cheapest, I have to say that. But I won't say it is a most convenient solution. It is a scientific solution, okay? But if we are talking about if this is the only way to deal with the wastewater, maybe not. Because the Japanese government or even TEPCO, they can always build more storage tanks. But the problem is, how many storage tanks are we going to ask them to build? Okay, so before they release the water, finally release the water into the ocean, they can always store the wastewater on site. Now the question is, they are afraid of limited space at the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant, and they want to get rid of all this very large amount of wastewater. That's why they spent quite some money on purchasing the ALPS system to purify the water. So again, I would like to say, if we can make sure that the wastewater contains only tritium and it has been appropriately diluted, then it is all right to release into the ocean, because this is really a scientific solution.
Last question, Professor. Some say this is a politically and environmentally toxic decision. What kind of lashback do we expect from nearby countries?
Okay. Yeah, I would expect the neighboring countries like Korea and also China, they would protest about the release of the wastewater into the ocean. But again, they have to come back to science. So I think they are doing the same thing as our government is doing right now. So we have to monitor the neighboring sea area, okay, to build a database. The database I mean here is the tritium database. So we collect and monitor the tritium concentration before the release of the wastewater. So we build this very large database to be the background. And then after the release of the water, we can monitor if there are any changes in the tritium concentration in the seawater. That way we would know if there is any significant impact of the wastewater to our environment. I think that's exactly the same thing that the neighboring country are going to do, okay? Because I don't think there is any way to stop, because the decision has been made and IAEA seems to approve this kind of solution. So I don't think there are too many things these neighboring countries can do for the moment, but they can do as our government is doing right now. So they will enhance the monitoring of the seawater near their countries and to see if there are any changes that is not normal. So then they would notify the Japanese government. If not, I don't think they can do anything else, really.
Thank you, Professor. We're so happy to have you on our program today. It's very assuring to hear from an expert like you and understand what really need to know.
Yeah, you don't have to worry too much, really.
Professor Yeh, thank you so much for joining us. And thank you, everyone, for watching. We'll see you next time.